What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Arctic Fox Gaming. I am Zio, and in this episode, and in my personal professional opinion, one great game has just been released for the PC, and that game is No Man's Sky. No doubt it's going to be popular among all of the Let's Play channels, but I'm here to give it a whirl and give you my two cents about it. I don't know. I've been waiting for it. I've been pretty excited about it. So let's just hop right into it and see what happens. Oh, I actually have to hold E. Here we go. It sounds like the portal lady. Wow. -4.5 degrees C. That's a tidbit chilly. Dude, this is cool. Wow. My scanner's damaged. Dude. Wicked. Oh, dude, this is so cool. Yay! Planet Upinganoshu. Euclid Galaxy. Dude, this is cool. I can fire my laser! Eat my sheep. Dude, this is cool. Oh, that's awesome. Wow. And all of this that you're seeing right here is all procedurally generated. Essentially meaning that this is the first time anybody is seeing this configuration on this specific planet of this specific system. If I was to go walk over there past all the mist, that would render in real time, and it would be different for somebody else that was to, say, come to this planet. It's absolutely insane what they've been able to accomplish with this game. It's the amount of technology and work that they put into this is by far some of the coolest stuff I've seen yet. What the hell is an Atlas Pass? But I don't have an Atlas Pass. I got a shield shard. And I got new technology. Phase beam. Spacefaring beam weapon and asteroid mining tool. Cool. I gotta go collect stuff now. Then there's nothing. Oh, I got a jetpack. That's cool. I found something. Looks like a gas mask. Isotope. Ooh, plutonium. Shift is run. Okay. Be right back. Un momento. Let's go here. Upinganoshu. Something like that. Upload discoveries and receive 2,000 units. So basically that means that if I scan something, any new discoveries that I make go and Max FPS. I like the sound of that. Field of view. Can only go up to 100. Go up to 100. Can I change my... What are my resolutions? No, I don't want that. Well, of course I want to do 1080. Yeah. Let's see how well this works. Apply. A restart is required for these to take effect. Okay. Hello, Mr. Mining Droid. That does nothing. What are you? Carbon. I'm mining. Overheated. Cool. There's my inventory. My backpack's got jets. I'm Boba the Fett. I bounty hunt for Jabba the Hutt to finance my vet. And in my ship I go. This technology is critically damaged. Oh no! Carite sheets. I don't want to discard or transfer. Oh, I can stack. I like the sound of that. No? Okay. You need 4 carite sheets to be repaired. And you need heridium carite sheets and zinc. Can I add... Nope, I can't. E is craft. Okay. Micro-density fabric. Interesting. E gets me in and out of things and interacts. Reality seems to fold in on itself. One moment I can see debris. Another, a vast red orb, almost too large and too bright to behold. It knows me inside and out. More than I could ever myself. Wow, I can't read. Could this be the face of creation itself? Or in my hazy, freshly awakened state, am I being manipulated? A name burns itself into my mind. Atlas. And a request made without words that I should follow the path this being, this Atlas, has set for me. I don't know. Considering the fact that this is a brand new game and I have no idea what I'm doing, I'm going to accept Atlas's guidance for now. I feel suffused with warm glow and glow of approval. I was lost, but now I am found. Cool. Wow, this is beautiful. The textures, the details in it, everything is beautifully done and rendered. Wow. This is so cool. Iron. I need some of that. Can always use carbon. Ooh, I hear animals. What are you? Oh, wow. You're beautiful. Okay, I gotta fix my scanner. Life supports are good. That's good. Here we go. Exosuit. Scanner. I need more iron for that. And I need to recharge you. Technology recharged. Okay, how do I activate my scanner? I think I just found my melee attack. A? No. No. There we go. Okay, so C is my scanner. Oh, I need to gather more iron. Oh, I gotta fix that. Oh, I really gotta fix that because I want to find out what you are. It looks like a deer kind of looking thing. It's beautiful. And it's making sounds. Oh, I love this. Iron. Overheated. Aw, man. This is gonna take forever. I'm almost there. I wonder how much iron this is going to give me. This reminds me a lot of, like, Minecraft, where you have to go and mine for ore and thing. Wow, 120. Holy cow. Okay, now I can come here and hopefully fix you. No! That's my zoom. Analyzing. Aconia, Actionia. Wow. This is so cool. You're beautiful. You are so cool looking. What are you? Titanium. Oh no, I scared it away. Aww. I'm sorry, little buddy. Plutonium. That's 75%. Oh no, 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 no. What are you? What are you? What are you? You're cute. Amagia. Amagia Hoania. That is so cool. Wow. It's a spaceship. Oh, I couldn't scan it. Can I scan you? Wow. I'm sorry if I just seem kind of a little overwhelmed, but This is beautiful. Wow. I'm being scanned. Enhance. I don't know, there's a question mark over there. I need to go to my inventory. I can craft beam intensifier Sigma. Mining beam laser is strengthened to speed up terrain destruction. I don't like the word destruction. It's kind of not cool. Technology installed. Can I level it up? Okay, I guess not. Starship. E to craft. Carite sheets. Another carite sheet. No, I don't want to do that. Starship. There we go. E, I need carite sheet. Oh, I don't have any plutonium to charge it with. Okay, so right click gets me out of whatever I was just in. Yay, I completed an objective. Oh, yeah, C. C is my scanner. Ooh, what's over here? Platinum. So apparently you can either mine certain things or you can get them from renewable resources, such as like the flowers and things that are on this planet. It's just pretty cool. Mining iron, because I know I'm probably going to need a lot of it. Well, that definitely went quicker. I hear something. I hear an animal. An enemy, Malo. Where are you? Yoo-hoo! I know you're out there. God, I sound like Elmira from Tiny Toons. I got a shield thingy. I can run. I need more plutonium, which is what I really need right now. Hello. Hostiles approaching. That's not good. Owie, owie, owie. I love how the music picks up for it. Keg! What's in the keg? My inventory is full! Damn it. Exosuit. How do I send back to ship? Oh, X. X. Cool. Life support's at 58. I'm good for now. Neutrino module. What the hell is a neutrino module? Yay, destroyed one sentinel. That's a big achievement. Oh god, this is gonna take me forever. Whee! Jetpack depleted. Wait for jetpack to recharge. And I have my stamina. Oh god, this is gonna take forever. Spaceships! Wow. This is so awesome. I mean, even for being procedurally generated, and I've heard of people having frame rate issues and things with of that nature, at least with the PC version. So far, I mean, I've only experienced maybe a couple of hiccups here and there. But nothing that's, you know, to write home about and to make me, you know, not wanna play this game. I mean, it's, for what this is, it's beautiful. Oh my god, that's a lot of plutonium. Okay, can't destroy that. There's a question mark over there that I don't know what it is. I think I'm gonna wait till My ship is at least a little bit repaired before I actually go and attempt to see what that is. If I ran... Are you Heridium? Okay, I'm too far away for that. And you are... Damium 9. You're nothing. Ah, there we go. Okay, the grid thing is kind of interesting. I need a lot of Heridium. I wonder if gravity works in this game. I mean, I know it does for the peoples, but does it work for big objects? No, gravity does not. I can literally walk right underneath this, and it won't fall on me. I wouldn't consider it necessarily a downside. You know, because this is still pretty freaking cool. As long as I don't hit the sentinels, I'll be fine. They won't attack me. And everybody will be all hunky-dory. This is cool. This is cool. I'm enjoying this game. Laser makes a fun, funky noise. I have a jetpack. And we got floating things. Floaty, floaty stuff. Almost there. Nice. Cool. Iron. Let's look at my ship and see what I need. I need carite sheets and zinc. Where the hell do I gather zinc? You know what? Let me go ahead and craft a couple carite sheets. Wait, it says I can stack. How do I stack? Okay, I guess I can't stack with that. Okay, now I just need to find zinc. Hello, zinc. Where are you? Iron. Ooh, what's down here? Oh, okay. Is it down here? Yes, it is. Platinum. Shield. Carbon. So the cactuses give me carbon. Ooh, cargo drop. Gek nip. Can I recharge you? Yes, I can. And then can I go to my exosuit and recharge this? Yes, I can. Oh, damn it. I forgot. Exosuit. I want to. Oops. Okay, I've got four slots with. Ooh, power canister. Plutonium, that's good, but I need zinc. Where do I find zinc? I have one of those. This card you allows beat traders to release delightful scented. Ooh, that's not good. That's not good. Yeah. Okay, I can use the power canisters. What are you? Valuable computer part, much favored trading item. Okay. So that's good to know. Okay. I think at least in this first episode, I'm going to just get my ship fixed and just try to get flying. Maybe not leave the planet just yet, but Thamium 9. I know I'm going to need that. Health at maximum. I like that. Okay. Plutonium. Zinc. Do I have enough zinc? Yes, I do. Okay, I do have Thamium 9. I do have Thamium 9, though. Oh, it's in my exosuit. Oh, I need a shite load more. Okay, I need more Thamium 9. Where can I find more Thamium 9? What milestone did I complete now? Oh, starship repair. Cool. Alright, my starship's at least repaired. What do you want? What I really need is Thamium. Oh, scanner recharging. You're cute! You are so cute and adorable! I wish I could take you with me! Wow, that's a lot of titanium. I don't know what I need it for, but I didn't do it, I swear. Yes, there used to be something there. I will go over there later. How long is it gonna take? 2 minutes! That's such a long time. I need Thamium 9. Please tell me you're Thamium 9. No. You are Platinum. There we go. Thamium 9. I need to collect as much of that as I can. There's a lot over here. Where? Where did it all go? Way down there? But how do I get to that? Well, that's not very nice. Oh. Oh, I see now. Thamium 9. More Thamium 9. Okay, that's good. Ooh, what's in here? Okay, can't mine that. Wow! Little red fireflies! That's amazing. That is so cool. What's in here? Ooh, what are you? You're nothing. I can't mine you. That's a lot of plutonium. Damn it. Ow. Ow, my ankle. Owie. That's not cool. I landed on the side of the wall somewhere. Yeah, I made it out of the hole. But I need more Thamium 9. Ooh! A knowledge stone. I now know the Gek word for give. Wasn't that helpful? Oh yeah, and there are numerous different, I guess you could say, races of beings that are scattered across the galaxy, and your whole goal is to from my understanding of it, is you're kind of like this scientist kind of person thing. I don't even know if I'm human or not, to be completely honest with you, so I could just be some, you know, random alien that is going about in a scientific manner trying to learn and understand the different cultures and different creatures and beings that are scattered around the galaxies. And from my understanding of the little bit of research that I've done about the game, is that your whole goal, I guess you could say, I guess you could call it a goal, is to reach the center of the universe. Not just your galaxy, your solar system, your universe. Can you imagine going to the center of the universe? Just thinking about it, even for half a second, is insane. Because you know how big that is? You're talking about planets and solar systems to galaxies, then to the universe. I mean, think about our solar system and our galaxy in and of itself. We're itty bitty peons compared to the rest of this universe. I mean, look at the size of our solar system. I mean, it would take us years to reach Mars. It would take us years to reach the other planets. I need to refuel you. Deflector shields at maximum. You are charged. Okay. Press and hold W to take off. I have taken off. Wow. This is so cool. This is way cool. And I can scan so much more. Wow, look at that. Those are either moons or other planets in just my little system here. Ooh, you know what? Let's go over to that. I have no idea what you are. I probably could have landed a little bit closer. Restore point saved. Well, that's convenient that it, you know, saves my spot whenever I get out of my ship. How the heck do I acquire an Atlas Pass? I'm interacting with a beacon. Wow. Okay. So there's two spots on my map that I should probably check out. Advanced life form detected. Advanced life form detected over there. It would take me about 11 minutes if I walked. What's over there? That's not too far away. Let's go to that one. Let's go to that one, and I think that'll be a decent spot to end this episode. But this is so cool. Oh, yeah. No. I want to get in my ship. Take off. This is so cool. Whoa. Where is it? You know what? This looks good. No. I know where it is. I just have to land by it. How did I land? There we go. E. E is my landing button. Where's that question mark? I'm not even close. Damn it, I did it again. I'm a dummy dumb. Take off. Okay, so it's over here somewhere. You know, we're just gonna fly this way for a little bit. Is that where I'm supposed to go? Is that it? I have no idea. Yes, it is. Can I interact with you? Exosuit upgrade? Sure, take the item. I don't know what I just did. Where's my exosuit? Oh! Stamina! Means I can run for longer. Sure. Life support charge with carbon. Starship. Plutonium. Okay, I haven't used my pulse engine, so I don't need to worry about that for the time being. Can I upgrade you anymore? Combat focused weapon use. User is advised that isotope elements such as carbon is required to recharge this device. I don't have any other scan. Can I upgrade my scanner? No. You know, I might as well charge you, though. Cool. Yay! Tokinangana Flats. Inventory full. Let's send you back to the ship. Okie dokie. What's in you? I got a dagger? A Viking dagger, no less. Interesting. Oh, there's my ship. Alright. We're gonna go to this advanced life form area and see what's over there real quick. Seeing as how I got my ship running in tip-top shape. I saw something there on the ground. I am definitely going to have to go back and check it out. But considering the fact that it says there's an advanced life form, that usually means that there is some form of higher intelligence wherever it's deciding to take me. I don't know why I parked so far away. I don't think it much matters. Shelter. This is cool. What are you? You are cool looking. Come on, hold still. I want to scan you. Analyzing. What are you? Piazza Yabiti. Cool. Jettison pod, nothing found. Gek charm. Oh, that's right. I still need an Atlas pass. Plains of... Where? Plains of Vivand. Cool. Vivand. I got more plutonium. That's always good. Yeah, I'm not... Like I said earlier, I'm not having any frame rate issues. I mean, I do occasionally, but that's only when... Oh, this is cool. What are you? Analysis multi-tool tech? Beam focus sigma. Faster mining... Huh. I thought I did that already, didn't I? No, I did the intensifier, not the focus. Oh, okay. What's in you? You look like a place that would, like, grow stuff. That didn't sound... Your standing with the Gek has increased. That's good, I think. A Viking dagger. Huh. No, wait, come back! So apparently, my language is the Gek. Oh! Can I fly you? Hello, Mr. Frogman. The pilot clicks its beak to indicate that it's open to trading. It might also be open to discuss the sale of its starship. Cool. Buy items? Can I buy items from you? That sell. Ooh, Gek charm. That I don't know what this does, but I have a couple of them. Good luck charm carried by many galactic traders. I think you deserve to have it there, little buddy. Ceremonial is a vital part of Viking tradition and culture. Plutonium, zinc, platinum. I can sell a lot of platinum. Okay. But, okay, now that we know that, what kind of stuff can we get from you? Unstable plasma? No. Don't know what I would need that for right off the bat. Do you have an Atlas Pass or whatever the hell it's called? Callium. I don't know if I need any of that just yet. Make an offer on your starship? $203,000 units. I don't have that much. But I am gonna see what's inside here. Oh, hello. Ooh. Interesting language. Galactic Terminal. Sell items from my inventory. Neutrino mod. This is okay. So that's just like buy items. So this is just like the guy that I saw out front, except I don't need to necessarily talk to anyone in specific. Analysis multi-tool. Reload accelerant sigma. Okay. Oh. Can I interact with you? Your eyes are cool. Why do you remind me of Spore? The small creature is busy adding up trade profits when I appear. Its eyes open wide with anticipation of our first contact. It rubs its fingers together greedily. It pecks emphatically at the monetary figures on its pad, then bounces up and down. I can't help but notice that it smells amazing. Should I pat you on the head again? For shits and giggles, I am going to do 10 units. Okay, I got cannon damage Sigma. Wow. Dyslexic moment. Photon cannon fires X at an increased rate. Okay. Operates automatically. Okay, cool. So this is neat in the fact that whenever you get done creating or obtaining a new piece of technology and you go ahead and build it, it automatically goes to your ship, especially if it's something that deals with your weapon system. Cool. My standing with the GEC has increased. I need 20 carbon. Interesting. You know what? I'm gonna go back to my ship. Oh, this is so beautiful. And I'm a dumbass for parking my ship way the hell over here. You know what? Since I have my ship and I keep exiting it incredibly stupidly. You know what? We're just gonna go up and we're gonna leave the atmosphere real quick just so we can get a glimpse of what this planet looks like. Wow. There's the planet. Isn't that beautiful? This is amazing. You are a planet. You are a planet. And you are a planet. And this is where it all began. How cool is that? I think. I think this is so cool. Look at that! You can even see starships flying around on the surface. Or above the atmosphere. That is so cool. Navigational data. Okay. Space station arrives in 2 weeks. Beacon arrive in 2 weeks. Huh. This is so cool. Well, I'm gonna leave this episode here. I think this is a pretty decent spot to end it. We've made it to the space portion of this game. I love it. It's awesome. If you haven't had the chance to at least see some of the videos that have been put up, I suggest you go do it. Or if you feel like being the adventurous type, go on out and get this game yourself. It fills an itch of mine of wanting to explore space. And being as how this game is procedurally generated, meaning that whenever I leave my field of view, everything from the plants, the animals, to how the planet itself looks beyond what I can see is all generated in real time. It's way super cool. So it's like you're going and seeing something for the first time. What you see on my screen is what's going to be different from what happens if you go and load this on your screen. And that's what makes this game so unique in, like, I would say the history of gaming. I would definitely suggest picking this up. I'm having a blast. I hope you guys did too. I apologize this episode ran a little bit too long, but I had to show you, and I didn't want to edit it because I wanted you guys to feel the same experience that I did, and I hope you enjoyed. Leave a like if you enjoyed this. Comment down below. Let me know what you guys think. And should I? And let me know if I should go to either of these three planets. Alright? Don't forget to subscribe to the Fox. And I will see all of you on the other side of the interwebs. Take it easy.